Hey everyone, this is Lady2and3 from IMVU.com. I was messing around the other day and I really wanted to make this one mesh and I realized how easy it was to do. So I'm going to show you guys how to make a butterfly to put either on your nose. It looks really cute in hairs or on rings. I like it on the nose and the lips personally myself. So first you're going to get your square tool. And you're going to make sure that when you draw it, it says square and that there are double lines. If there aren't double lines, it's going to turn out weird. I'm warning you. Right click, make unique texture. You can also tell if it's a square if this number and this number are automatically the same. So I'm just going to use a 256 because that's how I've already set it up. I'm going to go to the entity info, change it. And since I know what I'm doing, we need to rotate this like this. Okay? Double click, copy and paste over here. And then we need to... we're going to rotate this around now because... Well, butterfly ring... Excuse me, butterfly wings are mirror images. Just want to make sure I got this just right. There we go. Okay, on your second one that you just made, you're going to click out of it with your mouse, and then you do the paint bucket. You're going to right-click, make unique texture. And you should now have this material here and your material number one. Click material number one, edit, and make it a second color. I suggest putting a letter on your starting colors or whatever like I did here, especially on this mesh, because otherwise you'll have wings that are going every which way and it gets confusing. So you want it to be mirror image like this because butterfly wings are mirror images of each other. Take your sample paint and select your blue. You have to go under and paste it and it does the wrapping. And then do the same on the red, under and paste. Make sure you do this before anything else, otherwise things get weird. And I know because I've had to do this over and over and over again. So, we're rotating our two squares to the angle that we would want our butterfly wings to be. So I'm gonna have to scroll out on this one, it looks like. Then all I have to do is move them together. Hopefully are they together now? Whoops. Okay, so we've gotta move them together. You know what? Don't be mean to me. Well, you know what? We'll stick with that for now. Although when you go to make yours, I'd work on a little more perfection than I'm doing. I'm going to rotate these guys. There we go. Okay. After we've gone like this, just draw a square with your black mouse so that all of them is selected. Right click, make component. Type this in. Oops. There we go. mesh.attachment root.head.create. If you've seen my other videos, you know that this is very important. Do not worry that it is not on the head yet. The only reason we made it a component already is so that we can move it and scale it without having an issue. I'm putting mine on the nose, so we're gonna move it up to the nose right quick. It's way too big unless you like giant butterflies, so I'm gonna scale it down. You just hit S on your keyboard to scale. Then I'm gonna move it around until I'm happy where it's at. I find that this takes forever because my computer just does weird stuff, I suppose. I want it to angle because I want it to look like it's sitting on her nose. And no, it's gonna look different on every head you use. But it's good to have it basically correct in Sketchup. Okay, so I'm happy with that. I'm going to save this. Please note that I'm overwriting my previous file that I had. Everything you see is real. It's not like those cooking shows where they make it, but then they already have something pre-made. So because this is an accessory, we're going to use the IMVU File Editor, so export. Mesh saved, so we're good to go. Bring up the IMVU client, derive a new product, derive an accessory, that is PID, product ID number 682. We're loading. Alright, here we go. You need to upload both the XMF and the .XSF. When uploading, make sure that your attachment nodes are correct. For this mesh, you're only going to need it as head, no matter where we put it. And I'll show you that in a minute. Apply changes. And now we have this little square kind of book looking on our nose. So you can leave it like that, but you're not going to have a butterfly. So let's go over here. In your materials, the OO. I have some stuff that I've made prior. All you have to do for this mesh to work, go on Google, find a picture of a butterfly wing or a full butterfly, cut it off, and just do half and half, and in a 256 square, just measure it out so it's all like this. And then I'm just gonna make sure that I've got it on the right side. Nope, see, I have the wrong. Have it on the wrong side, so that's why I have it set so one is facing up and one's facing down. That way I have it right. So okay, now it's right, and now I can use this. Apply changes with the opacity, and look, now we have half of a wing. If we go over here, I'm gonna just assume that I need to use this the other side. You'll have to check it out with your mesh, because I've noticed each time it's a little different. And there you go. Look at that. That's uber cute. I love it. We'll use self-illuminated to brighten it up. Beautiful. Ta-ta. Now, how easy was that? And you know how well these things sell, too? And you might be worried. Can't zoom in on this. You might be worried about this right here. That's not actually touching, but that's really easy to do. All you have to do is go back in here and move it this way. Now, since we already have it saved as head, let me show you something amazing about this mesh that I discovered. Well, I didn't really discover it. I made it, but I taught myself how to make it, and I love it. I'm gonna get it all so it's all square again. Now, I like the idea of butterflies in my hair. I don't know why. It's probably a girl thing, but everyone knows that women spend more money than men on IMVU. And it's not, well, okay. A big part of it is that there's more stuff out there. Who wants to make guy stuff? That's boring. Sorry, I'm trying to take a moment to get this flipped around, just kind of yodeling while I do this. There we go. Alright. So we're going to I'm going to show you how to put a butterfly in her hair just real quick. So we're going to angle it. Angling. Lots of angling going on. There we go. Because we want this kind of back. Now one thing that's important to remember is that when you're putting something in their hair, you have to remember that it's not kind of hard to explain. This right here, that's her skull. That's obvious. But when you have hair, you might have hair all the way out to here. So when you're doing your mesh, you want to have one hairstyle in mind. For this one, we're going to go just like this. It's not touching the head at all. But this is where it's going to be floating when we upload it. So we're going to save this, export, and it'll make a lot more sense. This came up, which is good, because if it didn't, we'd be in trouble. Okay, and then we have to upload our XMF and .XSF again. I don't know how many times I have to remind myself when I'm doing it that I need to XMF access them, both of them. The node is going to stay the same, apply changes, and now we have something that's out here. So if we go to hairstyles and we put on something like this, whoops, I meant to get dressed first. Don't look at me, I'm default. I'm trying to think, do I have a big hairstyle? Oh, that's kind of neat. Huh. There you go. We're just sort of sitting on the strands of her hair. But you'll have to try it out with the different hair mesh, or the different hairs that you have, to find one that you want to make it for specifically. I'll try it on this one. I like it on this one. That's cute. And if you still feel it's out way too far, go back, move it in a little, save it, export it, upload it. Whoops, that's a wrong button, people. That is a wrong button. Start using SketchUp. Stop it. Thank you. One more time. We don't want to put a chair on her head, so we won't use the chair one. So now it's moved in a little closer. Try a different hair. Back to the first one. I recently found this first one, and I'm just loving it. So for some hairstyles, it's going to be wonky. And some, it's not going to touch. So it's the same when you're buying glasses or whatever. You have to find the mesh that fits your avatar. Anyways, so all you have to do is play around with that until you find one that you like. One that's close enough to the head, far enough away. Just looking real quick, because I had one that it worked beautifully on. I don't think I can find it now. But yep, so work on that.